Hey guys, and welcome to today's video. So today's video is going to be my fall layering combo video, and this is going to be part one because a lot of these fragrances with maybe one or two combinations are more hot weather approved. There are more fragrances that I like to wear in Florida fall, where it's still the mid 80s outside. It is a little cooler today. Today it's only 81 because it's raining, but a lot of these combinations are definitely fragrances that I like to wear more, that it's warmer in fall, but I like to create the feeling of fall. So we have quite a bit to go over, so let's go ahead and get into the video. So we're gonna start with some transitioning scents that I think are beautiful year-round, but I especially think are gorgeous for summer transitioning into fall. So the first one I had tested out that I'm surprised I didn't mention because it did get me a compliment. That is YSL's Leap Flowers and Flames with Coconut Sun by The Seven Virtues. This scent is a clean coconut scent that I enjoy wearing year round because I do think that coconut is a note that I prefer more so in summer. A lot of my coconut scents tend to be a little bit more suntanny, a little bit more beachy. This is like you were kissed by a summer vacation. It's not doing too much and it's gorgeous. So I had gotten YSL's Leap Flowers and Flames. I don't know if it was August or September. I thought this was going to be a more summery, tropical YSL Leap. So I decided to pop this on together, and it still didn't make it a tropical, summery YSL Leap, but it did make it a more coconutty Leap. Now this, I thought had a note of coconut, but it's actually a cocoa palm tree flower accord, which is creamy. This is YSL's Leap with a creamy top. The lavender in here is definitely more soft, more feminine. And then Coconut Sun to me is more like coconut water. It added a little bit more coconut without being too coconutty, and it added this clean kind of after the shower feeling to it. So this was a gorgeous combination. I popped it on and went for a walk with my mom, and right away she told me that I smelled good. So again, that's YSL's Leap Flowers and Flames with Coconut Sun. And this is going to give you a beautiful, clean, white floral coconut scent. All right, so for my cousin's recent 50th, which was Paris theme, I knew I wanted YSL Leap. Again, this is just, it's a fragrance that I know I'm gonna smell good. I know it's kind of a powerhouse, and I know I'm gonna get compliments, and I got several compliments that night. But I wanted to zhuzh it up a little bit. I wanted just something a little bit more. So I wore Flowers and Flames with the new Valentino Donnabahn and Roma Rendezvous the Gold. And this was a gorgeous white floral kind of coconutty fragrance. Now, this isn't a thick coconut scent. The coconut in here is very much in the base and adds a creaminess. And this was another one, this combination garnered me several compliments at the party. And my sister, which I was very impressed, she was able to pick up on some notes. She's like, oh, what are you wearing? And I'm like, well, it's a combination. And she's like, is it a white floral? I was like, yeah, it is. And she's like, is it a coconut scent? And I'm like, yes, it is. So this was a beautiful kind of, I would say, a golden hour transitioning scent. Very much the sun setting, kind of sexy white floral. You got a little bit of warm yellow florals in here. Beautiful combination. Another hot weather approved fragrance. Now, I do enjoy wearing this one on its own for the reason why a lot of people didn't like this fragrance, and that's Kayali's Yum Pistachio Gelato. I mean, a lot of people did enjoy this one, but a lot of people didn't because this doesn't smell like pistachio to a lot of people. I do get the pistachio, but I also get florals in here. I get a clean jasmine. There is something, I wouldn't say citrusy, but very bright and clean in the opening, which is probably coming from the bergamot. And it wasn't an overly gourmand scent. To me, this was more clean white floral with a gourmand touch. Got this creaminess to it. It's fluffy and it's airy. Now, you want to add a little more yumminess to it. I believe I've already talked about this combination, but I wore it recently, so I wanted to mention it again. And that is wearing it with Sol de Janeiro's Cherosa 62 and Boom Boom Cream. So this combination adds a little bit more of that gourmand touch that I feel was missing to other people, but also not being too overly gourmand where I wouldn't like it, because you guys know I'm just not a gourmand lover. With this combination, it does take down the clean powdery white florals that some people didn't like in this one. So again, that's Yum Pistachio Gelato with the Brazilian Crush Cheirosa 62 and Boom Boom Cream. Kind of keeping in line with clean, I think this is a nice scent, especially if you want to smell clean and cozy. And I don't know what it is about fall that just gives me more of a cozy vibe than any other season. Usually when I want to smell clean and cozy, I just go for Kaeli Musk 12. Fragrances that fall in this line, because I do believe this was discontinued, is Clean Reserve Skin and Clean Classic Skin. Now this I would say falls in the middle. Clean Classic is your skin but better, very clean, very musky. And then Clean Reserve Skin, that one gets a little too sweet. I believe it's praline. There is a note in there that in combination just got a little too sweet on me. This has a touch of sweetness. Another fragrance that is like that is Myth, the perfume. I do have a travel of this one, and I was debating whether to get it, but since I have Musk 12, I don't feel like I need it. Plus that one is definitely more, I would say, like the classic clean. It's more, I don't want to say detergent, but it's just got that clean scent to it, maybe a little soapy. Now these two together, the body oil with Musk 12, I don't know that I would wear it any other way, because I feel like that touch of sweetness is taken down even more, and this adds this touch of soapiness that I like. So this is a nice fall combo when you want to feel cozy, maybe with a nice hot cup of cocoa or coffee. This one's a good one. And again, that's Kaeli's Musk 12, or you could use Clean Reserve Skin with Ellis Brooklyn's Myth. So keeping in line with clean and cozy, we have a coffee scent. Now this one isn't overly coffee. I'm gonna give you what you could do to add a little bit more coffee, but recently I went to meet my friend for coffee at Starbucks. I'm going to a coffee shop, so I decided to wear a coffee break. Now coffee break isn't overly coffee. Coffee break is more of a feeling. Coffee break is like stepping into a coffee shop. It's super cold. You get the coffee aroma, but it's very light, and you get kind of a cedar base. Maybe there's furniture that's made out of cedar, and then you get lavender that's pumping through the vents. And that's more so what I get from coffee break. It's more of a lavender scent with coffee off in the background. Very beautiful. Well, I decided to layer it with Burberry Goddess, and I took this from Starbucks to Foxtail. I took this from a very popular coffee chain to a very posh exclusive coffee chain. Now I will say the coffee was a little overpowered by the vanilla and the lavender, so I did go in lighter with this one, but this combination together was magic. And I would say if you want to add back a little bit more coffee, you could probably layer a coffee lotion on top. So gorgeous combination if you want to smell put together, clean, a little bit niche. This smelled niche to me, this combination right here. So Burberry Goddess, the original, with Coffee Break by Replica. Gorgeous kind of vanilla, lavender, slightly coffee scent. Right, keeping in line with coffee, another light coffee scent, which reminds me I need to try this combination. But most recently I did talk about this combination for Hurricane Milton. I wanted something kind of comforting and cozy with a slight gourmand touch, so I wore Camra's Cahua. This is reminiscent to me of Angel Share with a slight coffee touch. It's not a dupe, but I find this to be more close to Angel Share than the original. This paired with Eden Juicy Apple was a beautiful combination. So this already, for whatever reason, gives me a slight apple vibe, kind of like Angel Share, and then pairing these together was just the fruity gourmand I needed that day, and I think this is gorgeous. You guys know that I have been on the hunt for an At The Fair fragrance, and I believe I found it, but it's a combination of, and that is Cirque du Soleil. I was only able to try a 2 mL sample, tried it on one arm, fell in love, then I sprayed it, sprayed this on top, and fell even more in love. If someone could please just make that, make Cirque du Soleil with a touch of apple, gorgeous. That is the At The Fair scent I've been looking for, because Cirque du Soleil is blended to perfection. Like, you get a sweetness that could be cotton candy, but it's not necessarily cotton candy. You get a buttery popcorn that could be buttery popcorn, but it's blended and swirled in such a way that you don't get buttery popcorn. And there's a vanilla, a beautiful vanilla, and then there's florals, and it's just balanced very beautifully. Now, I did pick up Dua's Circus of the Sun, and to me, you get those, but not blended as well. So you kind of get each note on its own. So I get the cotton candy in here. Now, the cotton candy comes in the dry down. What I get the most is a strong buttery popcorn in the opening. I get a vanilla, I get a sweetness, then I start to get a little bit of a cotton candy, and then the magic in this one is in the deep dry down. This one to me is more gourmand than Cirque du Soleil. It doesn't have as many of the balancing notes, but you might really like that. To me, the buttery opening is a little too much. It lingers for like the first 30 minutes, which is just a little too long for me to put up with the scent. But I did try it with Ellis Brooklyn's Apple Love. This took over, so this didn't even stand a chance. I did try it with Dua's Caramel Apple on a Stick. I didn't care for that scent. It reminded me of that BR540 and Ariana Grande scent profile. So that one just didn't stand a chance because I have enough of those fragrances. But if you like it, that combination was good. And then recently I did try it with Kaylee's Eden Juicy Apple and Country Apple. Again, this is so strong, I had to put the lotion on first, and then I popped on this fragrance. I tried not to go too heavy, and then I went heavy on Kaylee Eden Juicy Apple. The butter still came through on this one. It's just, I don't know that I can get past that opening, so I don't know how long this is gonna stay, but I do enjoy playing with this one. Now the dry down. This was gorgeous in the dry down. So I do feel like I would really enjoy Cirque du Soleil, because I think that scent with this apple fragrance is just gorgeous. It is what I've been looking for at the fair. I want popcorn, I want funnel cake, I want cotton candy, but I want it blended to the point where you can't tell it's that, with a heavy dose of apple. And I feel like I got that with Cirque du Soleil and this mixed together. So I think that's a gorgeous combination. If you have that scent, to try it, and if you want something just a little bit more gourmand, you want something a little bit more buttery popcorn, I would say try Dua's Circus of the Sun. I will say that they do different batches, I hear, so I don't know if they'll tweak this one. I think this one would be good if they toned down on the popcorn note. I think I would like that more. It's just a little too strong for me. Okay, so last year I talked about Lotus Pear from the Seven Virtues, and I absolutely love the opening. I love the first 2 hours, not even just the opening. I love the first 2 hours of this fragrance. You get a very crisp but slightly juicy, clean, fresh pear. This is actually part of my scent of the day. And this is very reminiscent of Viva La Juicy, but like a flanker. This is a distant cousin, but there is something very Viva La Juicy about this one. But if you saw my video last year, you know it's the deep dry down of this scent that I don't hate, but I don't love. It's like this earthy floral woody base, but without being patchouli. It's definitely more lotus. And it's dewy, it's earthy, and I don't know. I just don't love the dry down, but yet there's something kind of forest-like and enchanting about it. So it's also not a hate. There's something about the scent. I don't know what it is, but I keep trying to make this one work because I love the opening. And again, I don't hate the dry down. It's just something about it. So I tried this last year with Jean-Paul Gaultier's Labelle, and I enjoyed it. But again, this took over, and I was meaning to wear it again and revisit it, especially now that that one's gotten stronger. So I have to do that. But for whatever reason, I wanted to wear this yesterday, so I popped this on with Kaylee's Vanilla Rock. I can never think of them. The name is too long. But I got the same feeling that I got last year, which is why I'm not gonna go into that one. Today, I didn't think this was gonna work out. I don't know what made me try it. I think it was because of the pear. I popped on Ellis Brooklyn Sweet, and this is so light, so airy, and somehow, because I've already had this combination on for a few hours, and it's usually around the 2 hour mark where that lotus earthy, floral, woody base comes in. This combination works really well. I don't know what it is about the sweetness in this one, because again, this is light, this is airy, this is pear. It's got sandalwood, but the sandalwood comes off slightly a little bit in between like paper and pencil shavings. That's what the sandalwood comes off in this scent. But together, this creates a new scent. You still got that beautiful opening, but it's almost like whatever's missing in this one, because this also doesn't feel like a complete fragrance in the dry down. It feels like the top is gone and now I'm left with the base. This kind of fills that in, and this is a beautiful combination. It isn't one I would consider fall. It's one I would consider year round, but it's got this kind of clean, cozy touch to it that I think is beautiful, like right now that it's kind of dreary outside, and I feel like I'll enjoy more when there's just that hint of coolness. But it's definitely more of a year-round scent, but it's one that's nice. I still have to play with it a little bit more, and I'll report back, because I just decided to try this out today, and I've had it on for a couple of hours now. So again, that's Lotus Pear by the Seven Virtues with Ellis Brooklyn's Sweet. All right, closing out this layer and combo video with one that I think I'm gonna play with in winter. I just tried it real quick on the top of my hand early this morning before I put on my scent of the day, and even after taking a shower, I can still smell it on the top of my hand. And all I did was spray Valentino's. Now, this is limited edition, but this is Valentino's Donna Borden Roma Rendezvous Pink. I sprayed this one. And because that one has a beautiful, sweet mandarin orange, I wanted to try it with Victor and Rolf's Bong Bong. Now, this has, I believe this one has orange or mandarin orange. This one has caramel. This one's really sweet. So I sprayed one time. One time, this... and this. And while I was doing breakfast, I felt like I sprayed that combination on. Then I took a shower, did my makeup, and I couldn't smell it like I did before, but if I put nose to skin, I can still smell it. I could still smell this combination. So I think this is gonna be more cold weather approved, but I will play with this some more. But I wanted to mention it in case it's already cold where you're at. You like kind of those thick fruity scents around fall. I don't like them to be too syrupy sweet, but this is sweet. But if you like more deep, sexy, fruity fragrances, I would say check this combination out. So yeah, guys, that is my layering combinations for fall of 2024. Again, a lot of these were transitioning, a lot of them were hot weather approved, and then I have that one combination at the end. So let me know in the comments below, what are some of your favorite layering combos? I know not everyone loves to layer. I do. I like layering. I like having fun with my fragrances, especially because I feel like around fall, there's just a certain kind of fragrance I want that I feel like I don't get on its own. But that will do it for today's video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.